Richard Beck basically run the place. He, at the moment, after, 15, 16 months, we're financially solvent. We're in a position where a vast amount of the population have bought into what we're doing. We find that we're very well patronised and the place is thriving. The council announced plans to close the libraries. We went to a seminar run by the council at which they offered the chance of running the library to different community groups. We went to that seminar. We were competing with another group from the area. The other group subsequently dropped out because we could go ahead. We had a business plan, whereas they didn't. We submitted plans to the council for what we wanted to do. They agreed the plans and we opened up. We've got a 30-year lease and we're being given considerable help by the council, I've got to say. It wasn't a case of just cast us adrift. We have 62 volunteers. What we do, we have a rota so we can tell who's coming in at any particular time. We run iPad courses for beginners along with the UK. We have craft courses. We have a thriving ukulele group. We have a thriving choir with about 80 members. The NHS come in on a Thursday and they do a dementia workshop. We have an art group, but that's funded by Cultural Spring, as was the choir. The choir, we got the funding from Cultural Spring, we got £475 from them to start the choir off, but now it's self-supporting. And what we do with community groups, we ask for a pound donation. And of course, when they come in, they buy teas, coffees, that sort of. The idea is not to make the thing prescriptive because of cost. We try to keep our prices low.
I'm Anne, and I've volunteered here since the library opened. I was looking for somewhere to do some volunteer work, as I'm now retired. And a little leaflet popped through the letterbox. And I was so sad when I heard that the library was possibly going to close that I had no hesitation whatsoever in coming up and helping. So I've actually been here since day one of the place being open. I came in for the week we cleaned. That was interesting. And then I volunteered to do a couple of days every fortnight, and I now do 2 days a week. So it's the way that the place gets you, because it is so appreciated in Fulwell that you can't help but do as much as you can to keep the place going. And it's well used. We've had thousands of books donated. The cafe that we started up is thriving. It's a place for people to come and meet and socialise, and they don't feel as if they've got to leave quickly. They can sit and, you know, make a cup of coffee last 2 hours if they want to do. It is taking up more of my time than I thought, but I do not begrudge any of that time, because it's, as I say, we are so appreciated within the community. And we've done a lot actually to bring, I'll use the term, lonely people who would normally just come in and choose a book and go away again. They come in, they'll choose their books, they'll have a cup of coffee, they'll maybe meet a neighbour or they'll talk to us. And so it does that as well. So it's thoroughly enjoyable.